Gracias a todos por darme esta oportunidad de estar con ustedes aquí, especialmente a los organizadores, Carmen, Carmencita, que han sido muy amables en invitarme. La historia mía como Pedro sin pan la pueden tener y leer, que gracias a ella hay una copia en español y otra en inglés. Así que no la voy a repetir porque ustedes lo pueden tener con calma, la pueden entender lo que nosotros pasamos.
Thank you. For those of you that don't speak Spanish, I will try to summarize more or less what she's saying, but you can read her whole story in the booklet, in the leaflet that you were given at the entrance in English and in Spanish.
Gracias, Ivonne. Me gustaría hacer énfasis que mi persona, yo soy una persona muy preocupada por las pérdidas. No sé si es porque en Cuba hemos perdido tanto que cuando yo llego al exilio me doy cuenta que necesitaba comenzar de nuevo y necesitaba comenzar a estudiar la historia de mi país porque a nosotros nos la escondieron. A nosotros los que nos quedamos nos enseñaron otra cosa.
When she came into the United States, she realized that she would have to start all over again to learn the history of her own country, because what we were taught at school was totally different to the reality.
Dentro de eso, con mis primeros ahorros, comencé a comprar libros y a estudiar y a preguntarle a los exiliados históricos qué era lo que ellos, cómo fue, si era verdad que Batista fue malo, si era verdad que Fidel era bueno, todas las cosas que a nosotros, yo no creí nunca lo que nos habían enseñado, pero dentro de esas medias verdades que ellos decían, yo tenía que saber cuál era la realidad.
With her first savings, she started buying some books and interviewing exiles, Cuban exiles from the old times to find out what, to compare what she had been taught at school and the reality of those people, the things that their experiences in Cuba before coming to the United States.
Y entonces fue que descubrí a los Pedro Pan.
And this is when she discovered the Pedro Pan children.
Y me empecé a hacer comparaciones y pensar todo lo que los Pedro Pan habían logrado aquí, que era fantástico, y todo lo que nos quedamos sin el pan nos pasó en Cuba.
Then she started comparing also the achievements of the Pedro Pans, those children that had grown up and become successful entrepreneurs and people of dignity here, in comparison to those who were remaining in Cuba and without bread, bread in every sense, not only material but spiritual bread.
Y no era porque la falta de comida, porque no sé si saben que en Cuba al refrigerador le dicen coco, porque lo único que guarda es agua.
The refrigerators in Cuba are called coconut because the only thing they have inside is water.
Era sin todo lo que de verdad nosotros carecimos desde la verdadera historia, la religión, porque nos empujaban a ser ateos, los trabajos forzados para pagar nuestros estudios, a tener que ser revolucionarios si queríamos estudiar, o por lo menos fingir que eran revolucionarios.
Yes, and then she started noticing all the things that she had been lacking, not only in the material sense, but also in spiritual, religious senses. They had to work, you know, they were forced to go to work to pay for their studies, and you had to simulate that you were agreeing with a revolution. If not, you were probably being fired. That doesn't exist yet. It will just be against you, throw you out, and that's it. Nobody will hire you ever.
Y entonces también descubrí que lo que más nos faltaba era la esperanza.
She noticed that it was hope that was lacking most of all.
Y pensé que cuántas cosas tuvieron que sufrir los Pedro Pan separándose de sus padres, cosas que yo entiendo ahora porque soy madre y soy abuela, lo que tuvieron que sufrir esos padres, como dijo el maestro Valladares. Y dije, esto tengo que escribirlo, tengo que escribir lo que pasamos nosotros, porque se está menospreciando a una operación que fue fantástica y que ha logrado grandes personas.
Then she started considering the sufferings not only of the children that were separated from their parents, but also of those parents who had to remain there in Cuba, and some of them were never able to come back to see their children.
Yo tengo un pensamiento que escribió San Agustín que siempre lo repito: nada es querido si no es conocido. Por eso es que quise dar a conocer la historia de los Pedro Pan para las partes en español, que casi nadie la conocía, porque se hablaba mucho, pero en inglés, y también la de los Pedro sin pan.
That's why she decided to write the story as a comparison of what she lived in Cuba and the stories that she had heard from the Pedro Pan children.
Lo principal para que sacaran a los niños en la operación Pedro Pan era porque iban a perder la patria potestad. Pero los que nos quedamos en Cuba, también los padres perdieron la patria potestad.
Those who were sent to the United States because of the fear of the parents were afraid of losing the authority, the paternal authority, but in reality it did happen that way for those who remained in Cuba.
No fueron enviados a Rusia algunos, porque muchos sí fueron enviados, y a los países socialistas, donde supuestamente le ofrecían carreras magistrales, pero era lavándole el cerebro.
Yeah, some of them were sent to Russia and to other socialist countries to study careers where they brainwashed them, and of course they would use them for their own benefit when they came back.
Sino que dentro del país nos enviaban a las escuelas del campo, a los servicios militares, a los trabajos forzados de la UMA y a muchas cosas que los padres no tenían derecho a escoger nuestras escuelas ni nuestras enseñanzas.
There were so many things that we were forced to do with our children, to send them to the agriculture. Half of the day they were studying on the countryside, and half of the other day they were working on the countryside, cutting cane and so on. And they were forced also to be faithful to the government, whatever it meant for them. You couldn't do anything that you believed in. You were forced to do what they wanted.
Algún día alguien debe describir la historia que el maestro Valladar empezó sobre los niños Pedro Pan comparándolo con los niños Pedro sin pan, pero amplia en una buena película como mismos están haciendo esos documentales que quieren denigrar a la operación Pedro Pan. Gracias a todos.
We should do films comparing the two stories, but in a long, not only a short movie, but a long movie where we compare both lives.
Thank you. I felt to introduce our translator, Yvonne Martin.
I am a Petra sin pan. Actually, I'm not an interpreter. I am a translator, a written translation, as you would read in my humble mini biography. But for me, it's not only an honor to see you all again, because even if I don't know your names and I have never seen you before, I was about to be one of you. But for reasons of destiny, I could not come. And it took me 27 years to be able to come to the United States. And I thank God to be here with you, and I bless you all.